Financially raw, real, authentic wisdom with Lawrence Oberholzer from Retire Rich and Happy.
So we're back again. Lawrence, how's it going?
Hey, good and you, Damien.
Oh, no, lekker, man. Not too bad. It's Tuesday. I can't complain.
Yes. Yeah.
So we're chatting step five today, paying it forward.
Yeah, step five. And it's getting a little bit away from money. So if I go through the first four steps quickly, minimize your risk, invest in yourself, become an entrepreneur, invest in income-generating assets, which all is about money. It's about how to manage your money, how to make it work for you, how to create wealth. So step one to step four is about retiring rich.
Yeah.
Step five is all about retiring happy.
Okay, this is where the happiness comes in.
Yes, because it's one thing to have money. It's another thing to be content and happy.
Yeah.
And that's where paying it forward comes in. It's about making a contribution. We always talk about the pursuit of happiness. I think all of us want to be happy one day or as soon as possible. So we have this pursuit of happiness. And I watched a movie a couple of years ago that said it's not really about the pursuit of happiness. It's finding the happiness in pursuit.
Okay.
To go and find the things that you're passionate about and go live it and have happiness while you're doing it.
Yeah.
It's not the goal at the end.
It's about the journey.
It's about
the journey. As opposed to the destination.
Yes, yes, yes. So paying it forward is all about that. So what we teach people or what we ask people is go and find your purpose right now. Don't wait for it until you retire and say, then I'm going to pay
it. Yeah, I've got enough money in the bank. Everything's paid off.
Yes.
Now what am I supposed to be doing?
Yes, exactly. So find your purpose now and start doing it. Start working. If your purpose is to make a difference in the lives of young children, start getting involved. If your purpose is to make a difference in the life of older people, start. If it's animals, go do something that makes you happy.
And that's the thing. I mean, you don't have to, if you want to work with children, open up a school right away.
No,
you can literally go volunteer a bit of your time and you can build towards it.
Small baby steps, but just get involved and feel the happiness in doing something and expand on that. Because true abundance is experienced by helping other people and improving the lives of others. That's where true abundance is. It's not just about money.
Yeah.
One of the guys that I study his works quite a bit is Zig Ziglar.
Yeah.
And he said that you can have everything you want in life if you just help enough people to get what they want. And that's what it's all about.
It's a nice way to look at it.
Yes. So the more people you can help, the more it will come back because you're the source.
Yeah.
So in life, one of the universal rules of life is if you want more of something, start giving it away and you'll get more of it. Give you an example.
No, what you put out, you're going to attract.
Exactly. Because if you want more love, start giving love to the people around you and you will receive love back. If you want more acceptance, start accepting people.
Yeah.
If you want more recognition, start recognizing people for what they do. And automatically by giving it away, it will start coming back to you. And that's the same with paying it forward, making a difference, giving something up so that you can get it in the long run, get it back.
Yeah. Which is I truly believe in that kind of thing. Like you kind of have to put down the groundwork, and also when it comes to your fellow man, try and leave him a bit better off than you found him.
Exactly.
You
and
know?
It's not just about money. We tend to think, oh, I don't have money to give to charities, etc., etc. It's about sharing some of your time or giving some of your time away, giving some of your knowledge away, giving some of your support away, and through that, paying it forward and making a difference in somebody else's life. One word sometimes, just a word of support or a word of recognition or a kind word can make a complete difference in somebody's life. And we don't always recognize it and we don't always realize it. But if we live that way, we will make a difference. And it's all about making a positive contribution to somebody else's life.
It's strange because I think we as a society these days have kind of learned to live with our blinkers on. You're just looking at that finish line and you're like, this is what I need to do. Life's hectic. I can't, I can't see you, Omar. I can't go and help at the animal charity.
Can't do anything because I have to work on myself first. And that's the big thing is Gandhi said that if you be the change you want to see in the world. So we tend to become engrossed in this thing of blaming everybody.
Hmm.
Oh, the taxi drivers again are driving like madmen.
Yeah.
But then we also skip robots. We also don't stop properly.
We also didn't leave early enough.
Yes. So then we blame everybody. So be the change you want to see. If you want more law-abiding or law obedience in the country, be law-abiding.
Yeah, be law-abiding.
Don't throw trash around if you don't like the
seeing
road
it.
Being
yeah.
So be the change you want to see in the world. I always say a person's character, we don't measure a person's character by how they handle or act against people that they love or people close to them. You really see a person's character in the way they act or treat somebody that has nothing to give them, nothing to offer them. That's where a person's real character comes out. So treat those people that can't offer you anything with respect.
Yeah.
And that's where your real character comes from. And then the last thing before we take a break is trust your gut. If you go and you have the opportunity to do something good and you have that gut feeling of maybe I should do something about this, trust your gut and do it.
Yeah.
If you get into a supermarket and there's an old lady standing in front of you going through her purse for the last couple of cents to pay for her canned food, etc., etc., go and you have that gut feel of paying for
it. Yeah, let me just help. Yeah.
No, pay it for her. Because we tend to have those gut feelings of wanting to do something good.
Yeah.
And then we sort
maybe
of,
that disconnect is acting on
yes,
it.
Yes. And then we push it to one side. So go trust your gut. And then for the listeners out there, before we take a break, is I want to issue a challenge for the next 7 days around paying it forward.
Yeah.
Go out and consciously look for ways in the next 7 days to each day do one thing. Just one thing that improves somebody else's life or improves their day. Not improve their life, just improve their day.
Yeah.
But go and do that for 7 days. And next week when I'm here on Tuesday, if anybody has a great experience, please just share
that'd
it with
us. That'd be an awesome thing to chat about.
Yes,
yeah.
Send it in. Let's see how it works if we consciously go and just do one thing every day to improve somebody else's day.
Okay, fantastic. Lawrence, thank you so much for coming through. And we put that challenge out to you
yes,
now.
Yes, let's see next week.
7 days, one good thing each day. Let's see how you can impact someone's life. And then next week, Tuesday, when we've got Lawrence back, we're going to chat about some of your experiences. Maybe, you know, you really changed someone's day and possibly your own.
Yeah, definitely.
Lekker, thanks. Lawrence, thanks, have a good one. Nice to chat to you again.
Bye.
Financially raw, real, authentic wisdom with Lawrence Oberholzer from Retire Rich and Happy.